leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, this country is witnessing tectonic shift and making unprecedented progress in all walks of life in the country. India today is one of the world's fastest growing economy. The largest number of poor people have come out of poverty in the last 5 years. India today is a strong country. India today is a country that has the potential and the strength to respond to any of the difficult challenges and attacks that it has. And India for the first time speaks and behaves like a superpower in the world. And for the first time today, Indians all around the world, most of the Kumaranites, we have a global footprint from Australia to Canada to wherever in the world, we have the Kumaranites doing very well for themselves and for the corporations and the countries they are working in. And all of them today say in one unison voice that today the global standing of an average Indian is far higher because the Prime Minister has instilled a sense of pride in being an Indian today. Simple. Whether we want to continue in the path of progress that the Prime Minister has already showed us, or do we turn the clock back and go back to those days of anarchy and chaos? And the country is emphatically saying in one voice that the country chooses Narendra Modi and the country chooses progress. Friends, for far too long, all of us have stayed disconnected from politics. The reason why we all stayed so disconnected from politics was primarily because our representatives and our leaders did not truly represent us and our aspirations. They were so different. We, especially the middle class of the country, we were brought up to believe that hard work is important, that we need to earn our bread, that we need to work our way to success, and we cannot take entitlements for granted. But in the last so many years, the politicians in this country, the reason why we developed such a big revulsion to all of them was because they never connected with us. Because they did not hold those values that we held dear to us. But now the Prime Minister in the last 5 years is changing the way politics is done. He has proved that if you are hardworking, even if 100 people try to pull you down, if people are with you, you will still rise. That's what the Prime Minister showed. The Prime Minister in the last 5 years also showed that politics is not a path for personal enrichment, but if your intent is right, if your intent is pure, then politics can be the greatest platform to serve the motherland, and he is attracting young people. When was the last time, my dear friends, that you saw young people out of good universities with great education doing good for themselves, wearing proudly a t-shirt with a politician's name and saying, "Maybe Chowkidar"? When was the last time you saw that? So this is the tectonic shift that the Prime Minister has brought about in the country. So, dear friends, I would like to conclude by asking all of you, by choosing a fellow Kumaranite, by choosing a 28-year-old to represent one of the most prestigious constituencies in India, the Prime Minister has sent out a message to all the 60 crore plus young people in this country that he reposes great faith in all of them and he believes them. That young people are no more mere spectators and bystanders in the development of this country, but they hold a great stake and they will lead the development of this country. This is what the Prime Minister is saying. The Prime Minister is also saying that politics is no more arithmetic. Politics is no more calculation of which caste somebody belongs to, but politics is primarily about what we all can do for the country. I request all of you, my dear friends, that let us choose our nation above everything else.